I am Dr. Diban. I come from RK Diban and Company, which has offices in Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, Calcutta, and Pune. IPR is intellectual property rights. It previously used to be industrial property rights, but it is now intellectual property rights. Indian industries are, firstly, the problems are that the largest amount of intellectual property rights which are obtained in India are not by Indians. Almost 90% of patents, for example, are taken by foreign entities. And when I mean foreign entities, I mean foreign companies and their partners in India. So because of that, Indian companies are not in the patent field at all. So they are continuously being on the other side, which means they are infringing patents. It is not that they are not aware of IPR issues. They are fully aware of IPR issues. The problem is that the management of most of these companies, at the engineer level, they are all aware. The managements of these companies do not want to invest in intellectual property rights, number one. And the government at all levels, they only give lip service. They do not actually promote or even give any sort of assistance like most other companies in the world, most other countries in the world and governments in the world. They give additional assistance for IPR rights. For example, I'll give you one example if it's okay with you. In most countries in the world, if you have a patent or a patent application, you walk into a bank and the bank gives you a loan for development of your invention without anything more. They mortgage the patent or the patent application and give you a loan for development of your invention. In India, none of the banks, even those banks which their foreign branches give those loans, in India they do not. Now, if that were so, then we would get a lot of more inventions. Indians would file more patent applications and protect their IPR rights. The whole aspect is what I discussed in my talk earlier. We need to do proper searches before we enter into any field. It is always better to be cautious and do a complete search to find whether you are violating any rights, whether you are doing any such activity, and therefore it's very, very important to do those searches before you enter into any business venture. All right. So once we have that, there will be absolutely no infringement issue. So the way to clear it is not to have that infringement issue at all. The first legal process is there are different types of IPRs. Patents is one of them. So you must ensure, for example, that your technology, the way you manufacture your product or the product itself, does not infringe anybody's patent rights, number one. Number two, that the shape of your product does not violate the shape of any other of your competitors, which is a registered design. Thirdly, your brand name, that is, that you are using, the name that you are using for your product, is not a registered trademark of some other competitor. And finally, even things like color schemes. For example, the bottle in which you are manufacturing, the color scheme of your bottle, the advertisement materials, all these aspects, one has to be very careful, and it must be cleared through your IP department. Many companies do not have even IP departments. So you must clear it from an external IP attorney or an expert before a product is launched in the market. That would save a lot of heartbreak and problems for various companies. Main concept of this program was for management. How at different company levels, how can IPR be managed? Exactly what I said. This is one way that once you manage your intellectual property rights properly, either defensively. First aspect, in India, we need the defensive kind of protection. Once we do this defensive protection, we would protect the company from any problems from other companies. At the same time, there is some level of offensiveness, which means if you have developed something new, you protect your IPR right, then you will be in a position to take action or prevent competition. So both ways, management means offense and defense.